Our next honoree is Ruth St. Denis. And our next guest is a noted author who has written many books about the Denis Shawn era, including Soaring, which chronicles touring with the Denis Shawn Company in the Orient, and the Denis Shawn, the enduring influence. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Miss Jane Sherman.
If Ruth St. Denis were here, she would accept this award with a little talk full of wit and charm, and perhaps a wicked joke or two. And she would probably wear a costume like this Mandarin coat, which I bought in Peking more than 60 years ago when I was there with her as a Denis Shawn dancer. Because through all her years of touring the United States, Europe, and the Far East, she never lost her sense of humor or her wonderful sense of the theater. But her work was serious and sacred. She determined to bring the spiritual cultures of the Orient to her audiences, and she did. But when she was in her 80s, she once admitted to the critic Walter Terry, "I always knew they didn't come to hear my message. They came to see my bare legs." Of course, many did hear her message in her Chinese, East Indian, and Egyptian ballets and solos. And many saw the beginning of American modern dance in her music visualizations. St. Denis called the Denis Shawn dancers who performed these works her children. And she wrote about the Denis Shawn School, which she founded with Ted Shawn, that, "What I shall give to pupils as long as I am able is an incentive to go on and do something, anything, that is a release and a joy to the young artist. As she often said, however, I am not a good teacher, but I can inspire like hell." And inspire she certainly did. Almost the whole first generation of serious American choreographers. That is why I think she would be especially proud and pleased to take her place in this Hall of Fame beside her most brilliant children, Martha Graham, Doris Humphrey, and Charles Wideman. She was still an inspiration to their pupils and their company members when she died in 1968 at age 90. Still wearing her lipstick and her courage, still firmly believing in the good, the true, and the beautiful in dance. And so, dear Miss Ruth, wherever you are, we hope you know that you have truly and truly earned by your faith, by your vision, by your labor, and by your example, you've truly earned this honor today. Thank you.
Miss Jane Sherman. Now, I was admiring your portfolio here. May we have it for our archives?
If you may. Oh, right away?
Right away. We're not taking any chances. I want you to know that's the way we get things done around.
I don't know.
Okay. Someone's missing there.